sitting now.
Okay, this is Ballantine Burton Ale. It was brewed in 1933. It was bottled in, I'm sorry, 34. It was bottled in 1953.
There we go. How many more we need?
I think we're good.
This beer was aged 20 years in wood, given away free as gifts, and now it's been sitting in the bottle for 54 years.
Okay.
And there we go. No sound, so it's a little going to be a little low in carbonation.
Okay, good.
This is on eBay, but I got a good deal on this. It was only $20.
No.
Usually these are
This
was only $20 on eBay. Usually these beers go for over $100, sometimes $200.
You gotta sell yourself.
Warren got one that had Casey Stengel's name on it. That was like $200, right?
Casey Stengel?
Yeah. Because, you know, he was the manager of the Yankees, and the Yankees, Ballantine was the Yankees commercial sponsor.
I actually went up to Bloomberg and got it. I bought the guy's bottle.
This is approximately 9-10% alcohol.
No, it's company.
Smell it.
Ooh.
All right. Go for it. So this beer was brewed 75 years ago and bottled 55 years ago. There you go, Jeff. Wow. When they get this old, they don't really taste like beer anymore. They become something else.
Like one of the biggest breweries in the world, in America rather, would do this. They aged beer for 20 years in wood and then gave it away for free. None of the craziest microbreweries today do anything as insane as that. They just don't. It's like a, and Ballantine was the, was what Coleman is now, the biggest single one location brewery in the entire country.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Providing Glen Burnett is cheers. 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 Cheers.